Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to be going over the Ackerman principle or Ackerman steering. Now, I want to go into this because I'm going to start going into four-wheel drive and all-wheel drive, and it's an important principle to understand before I go into those. The name Ackerman comes from a guy named Rudolf Ackerman, who actually was the guy who patented this idea. The problem was, it wasn't his idea. There was a German inventor that came to him. He was a lawyer, Rudolf Ackerman. And so he patented the idea, but somehow his name got placed on it. I'm sure he did that, but so it's not really his idea, but anyways, he's got the name. What's happening here? So now, back before the Ackerman steering was around, some of the tires would slip because they would come to a different point. So what Ackerman steering, the reason it exists is that so your tires do not slip when you go around a corner. Now, how you achieve this is by having a central point at which all your tires are rotating around. So you can see that the angle of this tire, this inside left tire, is going to be greater than this outside right tire. So with that angle being greater, they can come to a central point, and then all four tires can rotate around one point, which means the tires don't have to slip as they go around. If these two had the same angle, then they'd have to slip around some uncommon point, and so it wouldn't work as well, especially at high speeds. So the Ackerman principle is great for solving this problem. Now, one thing that you have to see when you look at this is that look at each path, each radius. So each tire's path has a different radius. Now, what that means is each tire is rotating at a different rate. So the one on the outside travels a further distance than the one on the inside in the same amount of time. So it's rotating more quickly. So in descending order, the angular velocity of each tire goes from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4. That's the descending order. So this is rotating the fastest, and this is rotating the slowest because it's got the smallest distance to travel. Now, what does this mean? Well, this means your right side is moving faster than your left side when you go in a left-hand turn, and vice versa if you go in a right-hand turn. Also, what this means is that the front tires, because they're traveling a greater distance, as you can see, than the rear tires, they are moving faster than the rear tires when you turn. So this is the real reason that you need a differential in four-wheel drive. If you're in four-wheel drive on a pavement or something like that where you have enough traction, enough grip, then you're gonna need a differential so that you can split the speeds between the front tires and the rear tires. Otherwise, you're gonna have some buckling, it's not gonna work out, and you're gonna wear the tires and you're gonna be slipping, you'll have understeer. So you want it so that you have a differential. If you put in a center differential right there, then that would allow these tires to rotate at a different rate than these tires. And then you'd put in a differential at the front and a differential at the back, and that would allow each of these two tires to once again rotate at different rates. So this is important before I go into my four-wheel drive and all-wheel drive explanations, so I really hope this makes sense. And then I'll be going into these more complicated ideas of four-wheel drive and all-wheel drive.